This is Girl 9, Gone. A Maya Gray FBI suspense thriller. Book 9. Written by Molly Black. Narrated by Rosanna Pilcher.
Chapter 1. Brett didn't mind working his beat in the Three Hills area of Chesterford. It was one of the better parts of the town, with a few good restaurants and a smattering of expensive bars and galleries. It was the kind of place where his main job was to be out there, to be seen, and to occasionally deal with a complaint about a stolen wallet. Brett was grateful for that. He was still pretty new on the force, still getting used to what it meant to be a cop in a town like this. He still had the excitement that came with now being a fully-fledged member of the CPD, mixed with a sense of responsibility, because now the things he said and did could have a huge impact on people's lives. Brett was walking up South Street, the main strip as far as this part of town was concerned, taking it slow, not in a hurry. Around here, a big part of his job was simply to be seen, so that the rich folks felt that they were getting their tax dollars worth from the local police department. Brett kept a careful eye out for petty criminals and potential problems as he went. A part of him even wanted there to be trouble, just so he would have more of a chance to prove himself. For now, though, it looked like a boring night with no chance of...
Officer Sorensen, this is Control.
Brett grabbed for his radio. He should have known better. Go ahead, Control.
We've had a tip just called in about a disturbance near your location.
Where? Brett asked.
Hillside Park, just past the bandstand.
At this time of night, the park would be mostly deserted, but that just made it exactly the kind of place where addicts or the homeless might gather. It was probably nothing, but Brett knew he needed to check it out. I'm on my way. He hurried off in the direction of the park. It was just a block over, but even so, it was like stepping into a different world as he passed from a space lit by streetlights and the neon displays of bars to one where the only real light was that of the slowly waxing moon. Brett hurried in through the gates of the park, heading for the old bandstand. He had his flashlight out now, sweeping the area around him for trouble, the beam illuminating the branches of some of the park's trees as they rustled in the wind. Brett didn't check the service weapon he had by his side, because he didn't want to go reaching for it every time he felt nervous, but it was an effort of will not to. Brett looked around, trying to find the disturbance that had been called in. There was no sign of anyone there, no sign of anything happening. Brett started to reach for his radio, ready to call in that it was a false alarm. Then, he saw a dark shape ahead, lit by the moonlight. Was there someone there, standing near the bandstand?
Who's there?
Brett demanded, continuing to move forward.
Identify yourself. This is the police.
He half expected the figure to turn and run, not wanting the police to find out what they were doing there at this time of night. If they did, then should he run after them or just let them go? It was a quiet night, and Brett was eager to prove himself. Of course he was going to run after them. Yet they didn't run. Instead, they stood still, holding position in an almost unnatural way. Brett didn't like that. Didn't like it at all. He really didn't like it here, in this empty place, with the cold silver of the moonlight shining down. Brett kept moving forward. He had to. He was a cop. He did draw his gun now, trying to be ready for whatever this turned out to be, however dangerous the situation was. He kept the beam of his flashlight pointed at the figure, trying to make out what was going on there. As he got closer, Brett stopped and simply stared, horrified at the sight of what was in front of him. A woman was there, standing up, tied in place against a post that seemed designed to keep her precisely in that one spot. Her blonde hair fell forward over her face, obscuring her features.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.